two projects that have the phase 2-3 approval that have been submitted for conceptual because they don't have construction plans yet are the Juan Crespi Middle School Gymnasium and the Pinole Valley High School, which is basically the full campus. Then our next tier down, there are projects that have been submitted for phase 1 and received phase 1 eligibility approval through BSA. So those buildings have been identified to have to be approvable under the seismic mitigation program. That would be Richmond High School, Helms Middle School, Valley View, and Deanza. So those have phase 1 approvals, and phase 2-3 reports are pending or underway now. The Kennedy High School Phase 1 has been submitted to DSA for approval, and the Phase 1 for El Cerrito and King are just about ready to be submitted to DSA for eligibility review. And then we did go through and review all of these campuses, but they didn't have eligible. They
I just don't understand Riverside. That's something I don't quite understand. The minimum and why.
I'm not 100% sure Tom is here, but I believe I did not have eligible building sites.
Tom, can you talk to us about Riverside?
It's just a wood frame building. It's not on the list. It's got all that brick veneer on it, but it's only veneer.
Only veneer. Okay, that's good. I thought it was brick all the way.
So we looked. Tom did his best. It is a lot. I would say Gompers has a great chance because it's there. It could be taken to the state allocation board in the next few months and put on the uncharted list. So, but in terms of the conceptual approvals, in order to convert those to full funding requests, we need to have construction plans. So,
why don't you go back to that slide?
Sure.
With
that one?
Yeah. In the second page, these projects all have a construction plan.
Right, so that's why we're working through these DSA packages, and that takes some time. The engineering on that and identifying that minimum scope does take some time to vet and then you have to take it through DSA and get those approvals. But those are underway.
Can you see the second page? Those all have arch.
So Helms, Deanza, those are completed projects. So as soon as we have the phase 2 concurrence, we can get those submitted for full funding. Richmond, I think, does not yet have a project, and Valley View has a project.
Yeah, that's why I keep talking Valley View.
Some of these do have projects. So.
Okay. And Kennedy's already been done. We got their eligibility money already.
It depends on matching up the eligible buildings with where the work has either already been done or is planned to be done.
The one that you guys are working on that I don't see on here is Lincoln, the hardship application. Can you talk about that and give people
sure.
a little background about Lincoln and the hardship?
Lincoln is in a different category. It is not a seismic mitigation project. It is a hardship project. And This project stems from a 2005, give or take, modernization project that took place at the site, and during the course of that construction, it was determined that the foundation needed significant work, and so the work halted on that building, and a significant change order had to be put together, and that work had to be done, and so now we're going back and asking for additional funding from the PSC for these unforeseen work that was done at this site. That project has also been submitted to the PSC, and they are on here. It is under review now.
What's the timeline for that?
I would expect that it could go be in the next 2 to 3 months. There where they will review it. Now the difference with Lincoln is there's no funding. There's no bond authority currently available to fund that project. So what they're doing is they're processing it and they're putting it aside until bond authority becomes available to then take it to the unfunded list.
When is the next series of bond sale?
There could be a bond sale in the winter, but this is different than the cash availability. This is actual bond authority. So there's no bond authority to be given for this project. There will be, the State Allocation Board has taken action that they will be sweeping high performance and career technical education funds, and so as that cash comes back as available authority, they could fund additional hardship projects because those do get funded first.
Right, and that's what, about $1 million?
It was about $30 million.
No, I'm talking about for the hardship.
Oh, for the hardship, $1 million, maybe a little less, because it's only.
But yeah, if they sweep, it'll be about 30 goes to the top.
Right, it'll go to the top. There are other hardships that are also waiting, so it would depend on where, you know, what the value of those other hardships are that are waiting and where it stands upon. We don't know that yet.
And when do we think we would know whether they're going to do the sweep?
They're going to do a sweep in January.
Oh, they are
going
to do a sweep in January.
But the amount of money is the unknown part.
The one they were going to sweep, they didn't decide.
Right, so but they can still sweep that at any time. So
we're not going to do it after now.
Hopefully.
Can I hear from the structural for where they are with their application? What project do you need?
Warren brought it on with what you don't say. We're working on Dompers, Fresky, and Moreland High School. Dompers has been submitted to the PSC for funding, and we've gotten a letter back from the PSC saying that they disagree with some of the estimated quantities or unit costs, and there's a meeting happening tomorrow at the PSC's office to discuss that. Essentially, the PSC is saying that the value is less than what our estimated things it should be, and they're going to
discuss.
Who is
the estimator?
On Dompers, Imperial Consulting.
Well, come on up, Dompers. How do you plan to address that issue with Dompers?
Actually, do you mind if I speak to that for 1 second? The DSA and OPSC very clearly lay out what the basis for the unit cost should be. It's our understanding that Mercurial has used the sailor guides, which were the basis for that cost. And yet, what OPSC is now quoting is something that's different than their guidelines. And so we've got questions about that, which will be raised in tomorrow's meeting. Similarly, they have some questions about quantities. And from what I understand, you handed over all the backup data for that.
Yeah, well, come up and tell us what you did, so who you are, and put your name on the record.
Good evening, I'm President and Dr. Harper. My name is Dr. Liu from Mercurial Consulting, and I'm the cost estimator for the scientific evaluation for Conference and Moreland High School. We did submit our backup and online takeoff on PDF and our matrix for calculating the quantities as well as our cost coding for the sailor cost codes that are related to our cost estimate. So they have all our backup. We are ready for the conference call for tomorrow to answer any of your questions.